Welcome to Warriors Communications, PHS TV. Join us every Thursday of the month to watch how the students of Pocomoke High School develop, film, and produce this show. During the next 30 minutes, let us walk you through our world, the hallways,
classrooms, gymnasiums where our fans gather, and on to our athletic fields, where we continue to show our warrior pride and spirit.
And even into the hearts and minds of our students. Make a visit to Pocomoke High and you will see why Pocomoke City was called the friendliest town on the Eastern Shore.
Warriors Communications makes a connection between the real world and our world. Also, stay tuned to PHS happenings and events through Warriors Communications, PHS TV. Thanks for joining us and enjoy the show.
Though the leaves may be turning, students at PHS have not forgotten the summer of 2003. Let's see how some students and staff members spent their days when t-shirts were plentiful and the warm air gave no hint that September was approaching.
This summer, my family and I went to Florida, and the parks we went to were Wet n Wild, SeaWorld, Disney, and Universal. And we went back to Universal again, but we went to City Walk in the NBA Live, and we had fun. And while we were there, we saw Shaq. That's what I did this summer.
This summer, I went to a junior ROTC leadership camp that was based on a Marine Corps boot camp, and it was the most challenging thing I've ever done. I learned a lot of how far I can push myself and how far my limits are, and that, to me, that was just like the coolest feeling that I've ever had. When I was there, we went into a gas chamber, and we rappelled off a really tall wall, and it was pretty scary. And then we ran a lot, and like you learn discipline and everything, so that's what I did this summer.
This summer I went to Washington, D.C. to participate in Presidential Classroom. The session I attended was about national security. It focused on the role a democracy plays in the age of terrorism.
Looks like students and staff at PHS had a fun vacation to clear their heads before the 2003-2004 school year. And I'm Matt Powell for Warriors Communications.
Many schools nationwide are struggling to make sense of the testing and performance goals set out in President Bush's 2001 No Child Left Behind Act. We recently talked to Pocomoke High School's principal, Tyrone Mills, and this is what he had to say on this topic.
Ways that we can. Education facilities throughout the nation now are responsible for student achievement. We ask for high accountability as far as teachers are concerned. We ask that our teachers be highly qualified professionals along with educational assistants. So the No Child Left Behind Act is to improve the overall education of all students and for teachers throughout the nation. Our students are now challenged more with No Child Left Behind, and the fact that we are quizzing and testing our students in areas like math and science and social studies, and we have proficiency scores. We also look at how advanced our students are in reading and also in an area of geometry. So it affects Pocomoke High School in a number of ways, but in the long run, we are preparing our students to be the best possible students as they can be.
Pocomoke High School students and staff are working hard to see there will be no child left behind in Pocomoke City. And I'm Brooke Gillespie reporting for Warriors Communications.
Can you stay for a little while?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for coming to visit me. Love you.
Love you.
Although many people are put to nursing homes, it's not because they're not loved. It's because they cannot be taken care of at home.
According to a poll by the News Hour, the Kaiser Family Foundation and the Harvard School of Public Health, almost one half of all Americans think that people are worse off after going into the nursing home than before they went in. An article on www.pbs.org called A Nursing Home Alternative, Dr. Bill Thomas is striving to create a different environment for the elderly. Plants and animals are brought into the nursing home. Food is served family style, not on hospital trays. Residents are involved and responsible for the care of their environment. We asked Ms. Boyd, Pocomo High School, about this issue.
There's disease going on and who are unable to do much of any of their own self-care, losing their independence, losing family, losing those things that feel secure to them, many times will cause them to go downhill real quick. For others who have independence and can do some of their care, relieving themselves of the opportunity or the stress of making sure the medicine's on time, food is prepared and available, for them, it can make them feel much better.
Hi.
Hi.
The alternative to nursing home care is not available to everyone. But in the meantime, if you have a family member that's in a nursing home, go visit them to show them that you still care. And I'm Shalonda Pierre reporting for Warriors Communications.
It's the end of a long school day and you're ready to go home. You walk onto your bus only to find it crowded and with no place to sit. Buses have been reorganized this school year. We spoke to Mr. Covington, Vice Principal of Pocomo High School, about this issue.
The decision was made primarily to create a safe and more comfortable environment for the elementary school kids in particular, while at the same time reducing the travel time that all students who travel on our buses spend in any given day. This decision in and of itself reduces the number of students that ride on any one bus at any time. In fact, most buses now are under capacity rather than over capacity as a result of this decision.
Although buses have been reorganized to better serve elementary school students, the problem of overcrowding remains on some high school buses. This is Jason Waters reporting for Warriors Communications.
Parents, are you aware that your children could be getting you sued every time they get on the computer? Recently, the music industry has been suing many kids' parents because of illegal downloading, sharing, and burning of music. Fines of up to $2,000 have been issued so far. If you didn't know all the facts and details about this mishap, you should listen to this. A recent PHS survey has shown that 67% of students currently download and share music illegally. The music industry is policing the internet and watching for file swap. If this is happening from your home, be aware you could be the next one sued.
Yes, I used to download music from Kaza. I had to get rid of it so I wouldn't go to jail.
Yeah, I download music all the time.
Yeah, I used to download music from Morpheus.
No, I don't download music, and if you do, you should stop now.
The times are changing in the entertainment industry, and piracy is a serious offense. So if what you listen to in your spare time is illegal, remember, no downloads are safe. And I'm Robbie Godwin for Warriors Communications.
Pocomo High School has an outstanding reputation for fall sports. The soccer team is coached by Mr. Allen Burr. The Warriors are off to a very good start. Keep up the good work, fellas. Such an aggravation. Accusations, don't know how to take them. Inspirations, getting hard to fake it. Concentration, never ready to break it. Situation, never what you want it to be. Cross country is practicing very hard to beat their individual and team records from last year. They're a very talented group of people. Good luck. Field hockey team coached by Ms. Pusey is having a good year so far. They are young but strong and are working very hard. Team is a group of dedicated athletes that are working hard to improve their golf scores each match. The golf team made a special presentation to Dirk Parsons on his 90th birthday. Mr. Parsons is a great supporter of the Pocomo High School golf team and youth golf in Pocomo City. The volleyball team started off this season with a big win. They have made big improvements this year. Good luck, ladies. This is Marco Crawford reporting for Warriors Communications.
There had been you, where would I be if there hadn't been you?
Did your relationship begin well and then go down the drain? If so, here are some tips and warning signs to help you and your partner. 1 in 3 teen relationships are abusive. Would you recognize the warning signs? Does your partner call you names, embarrass you, or make you feel stupid? Are you afraid or scared of your partner? Do they make excuses for mistreating you? According to www.cdvp.org, if you answered yes to any of these questions, you could be in an abusive relationship.
If you find yourself in this situation, you need to talk to a parent, teacher, or guidance counselor for help with these issues. And I'm Jamie Brittingham reporting for Warriors Communications.
Did you know that it is physically impossible to lick your elbow? This didn't stop these people from trying.
Motivation, such an aggravation. Accusations, don't want to take them. Inspirations, getting hard to fake it. Concentration, never ready to break it. Situation, never what you want it to be.
I guess we learn something new every day. And I'm Billy Connery from Warriors Communications.
New students aren't the only new people attending PHS this 2003-2004 school year. Warriors Communications is proud to introduce you to 4 new staff members at PHS. Mr. Burton returns to PHS as band director. He also teaches music theory, spring, jazz, and fall band, and we are glad he's back. We are happy to have Kim Baker, athletic trainer, here full-time to evaluate and treat athletic injuries and to help keep our athletes safe and healthy. Miss Ronnie and Miss Lamberson are leading the way for Pocomoke's band front. Miss Ronnie also teaches American music and chorus. Welcome to all new staff at PHS, and I'm Crystal Gasting for Warriors Communications.
First day of fall. And what's in my closet? Tank tops, shorts. I need Detective Fall.
Lost fall fashion?
No, that isn't it.
What about this
one? Nope. We're getting closer, though. I can feel it.
This is useless. Come with me.
Okay. Where are we going?
To find more fall fashions.
Okay. That's how you like it, huh? That's how you like it, huh? That's how you like it, huh?
That's how I like it. I like the way you brush your hair. I like the stylish clothes you wear. It's just a real thing to do. That's why I wanna stick with you. With my girls, I let them know we love that.
Is that your lost fall fashion?
Yes, that's it. I thought it would be lost all through winter.
Another case solved by Detective Fall.
I'm Jane Brittingham.
And I'm Jason Waters.
Reporting for Warriors Communications.
This year at PHS, students and staff may have noticed a new addition to the morning announcements. Every morning before class, Mr. Mills, PHS principal, recites the new Pocomoke City Public Schools mission statement.
The Pocomoke City Public Schools, an enthusiastic for learning partnership of parents, educators, and community agencies, empowers all students to meet rigorous academic standards and to develop into responsible, involved, lifelong learners who can excel in their endeavors, contribute positively to their society, and fulfill their personal dreams.
The new mission statement is actually just one element of PHS's campaign for Accreditation for Growth, or AFG.
AFG
is accreditation for growth. It is a process of school improvement. We examine all aspects of our students' lives, where we look at our facilities, we look at our educational programs, we look at our finances, we look at the cleanliness of our building. We get input from students, from parents, from community members, so that we can improve our school in any possible way. Accreditation for growth comes from the Middle States Association, and through an accreditation process, we will try to achieve all the goals that are set before us. For the Pocomoke area schools, namely Pocomoke High School, we're looking at improving our academic performance, improving our proficiency as far as technology for our students and our staff, and we also look at the responsibility of students in the area of character. Well, all students and staff members here at Pocomoke High School in the accreditation for growth process have taken part in it. All of our students have taken part in a standard survey where they examine the process as far as how we educate them. We also ask students for suggestions on how to better improve the educational programs. We do the same for our staff. All of our staff members have taken part in a standard survey where we get their input as far as curriculum, the rigorous programs that we offer our kids. Are they tough enough? Do we need to delete some things? Do we need to add some things? So as far as Pocomoke High School is concerned, everyone is a player as far as the accreditation for growth process.
The staff is working hard to meet all AFG requirements. Students, make sure you do your part to further the cause. And I'm Matt Williams reporting for Warriors Communications. Hurricane Isabel made her presence known on Delmarva on September 18th, leaving behind a path of destruction that stretched from North Carolina all the way up the coastline. While the eastern shore, thankfully, had considerably less damage than some predicted, there was plenty of work to be done on the days that followed. Many people had to go without electricity, and some woke up with tree limbs attached to their homes. Some people even suffered the losses of their sheds and other less stable buildings. Warriors Communications reporter Jamie Brittingham was on the scene before Isabel got too ferocious. Let's go over to Jamie and see how she weathered the storm.
Down here in Red Hills, Virginia, behind me is Cactus Cove. I'm out here in Hurricane Isabel of 2003. As you can tell, it is very, very windy, and the water has done a little flooding. Behind me is the Shigatik Bay, and it's getting a little rough, and the winds are about from 30 to 50 miles an hour winds. So, kind of scary. It's flooding! People are watching! This is the biggest hurricane I've ever been in! And I'm Jamie Brittingham, reporting for Warriors Communications!
Stores sold out of hurricane necessities such as bottled water as people crowded to the market in last-minute attempts to prepare themselves for possible disaster. Downtown Cypress Park flooded, making it inviting for young thrill-seekers. Isabel was powerful, but the people of Pocomoke and the surrounding areas stuck it out, showing both courage and a great deal of patience. And I'm Matt Williams reporting for Warriors Communications.
Take a little walk to the edge of town. No, spread your wings.
Like scary movies.
Uh-huh.
What's your favorite scary movie?
Oh my gosh, who is this? Hello? It's none of your business what my favorite scary movie is, dang. God, it's always calling me, bothering me. Oh, don't you hate it when those dumb victims in scary movies are always messing up and getting themselves killed? I do. Teenagers are scary movie experts. So Words Communications wants to show you the do's and don'ts of surviving your scary movie, just in case you find yourself in a compromising situation this Halloween. Starters, why is it these dummies always seem to run up the stairs instead of out the door? That's so stupid to me. I'm about to demonstrate to you the right way to do it. Should I run up the door or should I go up the stairs? I'm picking the door.
If you're face to face with the killer and you've got him where you want him, don't just hit him once and run, because he'll get up and he'll get you. Instead, hit him so he knows you mean it. Don't stop until you know he's not getting up again.
Remember in those Scooby-Doo reruns where Freddy would say, "Come on, gang, let's split up." Well, if you find yourself in a scary movie situation, don't take Freddy's advice. Trust me, he wouldn't have made it through Scream 1. If you're in a group or gang, don't split up. There's only one killer, so jump in.
So now you know a few of the realistic ways to survive a scary movie. We hope you never have to use them, but in case you do, please don't pull Drew Barrymore and die in the beginning. Use your head. And I'm Chandra Turner reporting for Warrior Communications.
The world is a really small place. At Pokemon High, we have 3 new foreign exchange students.
Warrior Communications asked Helena Pozova, Christian Hushtubek, and Miriam Vogel about their experiences in America thus far.
I am from Czech Republic in the middle of Europe. I prefer to go to the United States than to go to England because of pronunciation. I like it better, so I decided to go to the United States. The best, of course, volleyball. The team, Mrs. Butler, of course.
I come from Germany, from a small town called Eimbeck. It's about 30,000 inhabitants. It's small German town. What do I really like? I don't really know because it's different than in German schools. So it's the sport program is pretty good.
I'm from Germany. I like the atmosphere here. It's very tolerant, very nice people. I like everything here. I like the food, the lessons, the teachers.
See, the world is a really small place. It's a wonderful thing to have kids from different countries come together and learn. And I'm Mark Hill reporting from Warriors Communications.
Behind me is the Chesapeake Bay. I mean, what is it?
A junior ROTC leadership camp in Virginia. Where'd I go again?
Stay together. Jump the killer. There's only one of them. And I'm Shalom.
Oh, that's your part. Oh. I can do more than you here today.
What are we doing to get back?
John? I'm about to use this as a prop!